Floating in the sea.
Millions of tons of rubbish in our oceans.
And it can take centuries to degrade.
I went scuba diving in Greece. I looked around me and I just saw more plastic bags than fish. And I was disappointed and shocked by that, that I asked myself the question, why can't we clean this up? Yeah, that's the question that has been keeping me busy for all these years, ever since. By far the largest accumulation of trash in the world is the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. These vast ocean garbage patches, they're so far away from land that this plastic just stays there indefinitely and just keeps becoming more and more polluted. So that's why we thought, well, why don't we build long floating barriers that are driven by the force of the ocean and thereby allow us to really concentrate the plastic before taking it out and shipping it to land for recycling. What we've been able to create from the plastic we captured in the Great Pacific Garbage Patch last year are sunglasses, which are actually truly made from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. So every pair of sunglasses will allow us to fund the cleanup of an area equating to 24 football fields.
If something happens and these devices no longer function as designed, if they break apart and they begin to drift, they then become potentially the largest form of man-made debris in the ocean. And at that point, there really is no telling how it can interact and affect marine life of all sorts. So for now, we must look at how we turn off that tap and move upstream and reduce the amount of plastics that are being produced, the amount of plastic waste that is being created. And then when we are focusing on cleanup efforts, targeting areas closer to shore or in many cases in river mouths where plastics are far more concentrated and that do not pose the same type of risk to animals and other ocean habitats.